Ok.
¿Qué le hacen? Polarization is measured as the induced dipole moment per unit volume. Manto ye baat. Therefore, P is induced dipole moment kini hoi bete? QID over A into D. ठीक है, induced dipole moment per unit volume. जेरे आ सारे negative 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 हैं, एक क्यों आई हैं, ये भी सारे क्यों आई हैं. This entire can behave like a single dipole of charge minus QI and this is a charge plus QI. Therefore, the induced dipole moment would be QI into D upon because बच्चों अगर material ही ज़्यादा पाएगा तो dipole moment तो ज़्यादा हो ही जाएगी. But I think dipole moment per unit volume is a better measure of polarization rather than dipole moment only. ठीक है, so it is an induced dipole moment per unit volume and this would be QI upon A. This would be sigma I. Thus polarization is numerically equal to the induced surface charge density. Polarization is numerically equal to the induced surface charge density. The induced electric field within the dielectric. The induced electric field within the dielectric EI can be sigma I by epsilon. ठीक है, अपने को इतना लग रहा है जब हम अंदर कुछ नहीं है. We have minus QI charge here, plus QI charge here, and the induced electric field is sigma I by epsilon. I hope you are with me. The net electric field is E naught minus EI equal to E naught minus sigma I by epsilon naught, and sigma I is actually P. P is actually epsilon naught into chi A A by epsilon naught, or P is E naught minus chi A into B, E into 1 plus chi A is E naught, or 1 plus chi A is E naught by E, or 1 plus chi A is equal to K. Let me quickly revise the entire thing. How I wanted to do it. Polarization is basically the alignment of induced or permanent dipoles along the direction of the applied electric field. Okay, the applied electric field in this case is going, rather in most cases, is always a parallel plate capacitor, and the region between the plates is the region of a uniform electric field. As the alignment of the dipoles takes place, we have the thin edge AB induced with a minus QI charge and the thin edge CD induced with a plus QI positive charge.
we measure polarization as the induced dipole moment, because the dipole moment has been induced dipole moment per unit volume. Whereas we assume this all chote negative to be equal to a single minus qi charge, and all of these chote positive to be a single plus qi charge. And the separation between the plates is d, and the dielectric completely filled the region. That is what makes the induced dipole moment to be charged into the separation between them, which is not necessarily 2a. If it is d, we will write it as qi into d. Thus, the induced dipole moment per unit volume. The main definition of polarization is the induced dipole moment per unit volume. The definition is the alignment of the induced or permanent dipoles along the direction of the dielectric field, and we measure it as the induced dipole moment per unit volume. Induced dipole moment per unit volume. Okay? Now, the polarization of the dielectric is directly proportional to the reduced value of the electric field within the dielectric. And P is equal to epsilon naught into chi e into e. Chi e is called electric and is dimensionless. Aap check karke dekh sakte ho. Actually, epsilon naught dala hi hua hai. We want to keep it dimensionless. Bahut puchne paper. So basically, we have introduced the three separate things. We have introduced three separate things. Polarization, as we studied it earlier, as a definition. Then we measured polarization as the induced dipole moment per unit volume and said that it is equal to the induced surface charge density. And then we said that the polarization independence is then a lagla. And then we said that the polarization is directly proportional to the reduced value of the electric field within the dielectric, and introduced another term called electric susceptibility. Then we want to introduce a result, and we assumed the slab to be made up of two thin plates having charges minus qi and plus qi. Agar waqai aisa hunda, then the field within the A field in this region is actually sigma by epsilon naught. Has been a अच्छा जरा e naught है. That is also sigma by epsilon naught. But that is the surface charge density on the plates, about which I have not even talked about, because I want to keep e naught as e naught. थोड़ा याद रखना पड़ेगा. Because writing e naught as sigma by epsilon naught is not wrong, but I don't require it here. On the other hand, I have written the induced electric field as sigma I by epsilon naught, where sigma I are the induced charges appearing on the surfaces due to polarization. Okay? We remember that E is always E naught minus EI. E naught minus sigma I by epsilon naught from here. Sigma I is numerically equal to P. P by epsilon naught, P is equal to epsilon naught chi into E. It's revisited all over again. And then we get this result, 1 plus chi e is equal to k. Show that, define dielectric constant and show that it is equal to 1 plus chi e. Define dielectric constant and electric susceptibility and find the relation between them. Yeah. It's not so easy. You have to know the entire thing back. Take it. One more, one little thing will remain, well, we can repeat it. Dielectric strength. Dielectric strength. एक और छोटी सी चीज रहेगी लेकिन उस टाइप शील्डिंग मेरे को कल याद कराना ये पेपर में आती है छोटी छोटी बातें डायलेक्ट्रिक स्ट्रेंथ इट इज द मैक्सिमम इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दैट कैन एग्जिस्ट विद इन द डायलेक्ट्रिक विदाउट इट्स इलेक्ट्रिकल ब्रेकडाउन It is the maximum electric field that can exist within the dielectric without its electrical breakdown.
units volt per meter, electric field again. If we apply an electric field, greater than the dielectric strength of the material, it will lose its insulating properties and become a conductor. If we apply an electric field greater than the dielectric strength of the material, then it will lose its insulating properties and will become a conductor.
इधर मतलब अगर अपन किसे मटेरियल दे बेच ज्यादा पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अप्लाई करना है तो वी शुड यूज द मटेरियल हैविंग अ लार्ज वैल्यू ऑफ डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेस
ठीक है लोड पावर यूजिंग अ मटेरियल विद लार्ज डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेंथ will enable us to use a large potential difference across the material. ठीक है? प्रॉब्लम समझ आई बेटा का? वैक्यूम दी इलेक्ट्रिक सेप्टेबिलिटी कितनी होगी? यू कैन दिस आंसर टू मी टुमारो के वैक्यूम दी डायलेक्ट्रिक स्ट्रेंथ और इलेक्ट्रिक सेप्टेबिलिटी द की आंसर है. इफ यू थिंक यू विल गेट योर आंसर करेक्टली, वैक्यूम डज नॉट हैव एनी मटेरियल्स टू बी पोलराइज्ड. Electric susceptibility will be zero and strength exactly. So kya hai ji, vacuum has a electric susceptibility equal to zero and direct strength to be infinite. How does that work? Dielectric constant is actually, you know, K is equal to E naught by E. Okay? And it can also be written as, you know, in terms of V kitna hoga. E naught is actually V naught by D, and this is V by D, thus it is V naught by V, and it is also C naught by C K. V naught is Q by C naught and Q by C, and it can also be written as
C by C naught.
It might help you here and there. So K is E naught by E equal to V naught by V equal to C by Now the only way that we can learn more is by taking tests. I'm still left with electrostatic shielding, infinite network of capacitors. So let's keep our test on a little test on only capacitors ka bhi dena chahta hu na, wo to class test hi hai, discussion doubt type hi hai, matlab ye Wednesday de do only capacitors wale, taiyari ho jayegi capacitors ki sari, wale capacitors ki taiyari ho jayegi, then on Friday we can take a complete test. ठीक है, big पूरा electrostatics, and on Sunday we can take a multiple test. ठीक है, so you are in with the good week for electrostatics revision on your phone. तैयारी तभी होती है जब हम खुद पढ़ते हैं. ठीक है, numerical work चल रहा है, doubt उठ गई, पूछो अभी, पूछो कोई 10 मिनट है अपने पास, कितने पांच बजे होती है अभी तो, पांच बजे पांच एंट्री भी होती है. डाउट कोई मुझे दे ये किया ही नहीं कुछ, डाउट नहीं है अभी, चलो अभी तो हम किया नहीं कुछ है डाउट, चलो कल करेंगे जी फिर. अभी एनर्जी वाले क्वेश्चन कर लिया आपने, एक बड़ा अच्छा क्वेश्चन है, एक कैपेसिटर है, एक की है लगी हुई है, तो कैपेसिटर में एक में अगर डाल दिया डायरेक्ट ब्रेक एक में निकाल लिया, आपने देखा नहीं क्वेश्चन क्या नहीं लगता, हाँ टिपिकल में करो बैठ के क्वेश्चन कुछ नहीं है, यू आर इन फॉर टेस्ट. ठीक है जी,
पहले पास में